Hi, my name is Nate from the Tynker Dev team, and I want to show you today how to use the AR library. Now, AR stands for augmented reality, which means we're combining virtual and physical elements with the use of a camera. And if you don't have a webcam, just sit back, relax, and I'll show you how cool this is anyway. Today, we're going to make a simple game I like to call Wipe Away. And the game works by trying to clear the entire screen of these tiles by waving your hands and moving your face. So the game works like this. Oh man, here we go. Oh, getting there. <sighs> 23 seconds. I feel like that's a good score, but I think you guys are going to do better. Now let's get to coding. To start with a blank project. Now we're only going to need two things for this game, which is pretty great. One of those things is not Cody, so we're going to go ahead and delete him now. We're going to add an actor from the media library. I'm going to use this green square, and we're going to go ahead and call this tile. And we're going to get started. First thing we want to do is to add the AR library. So we do that by going to new, AR. Once you click that, it's added to your project. We're going to click on this, turn the video on, and to make sure we don't cover up any of our progress later, we're going to set the video transparency to 50%. We're also going to bump up the size of the tile to 150%. We're going to run this. See? Hello. So now that we know the webcam is working, we're going to set aside the AR code for now. We're going to go over here, and we want to keep track of how many tiles we're going to have during this game. So we're going to create a variable, call it tiles, and we're going to set it to for all actors only, which is a global variable, which we can use at a different actor later. Create. For now, we have 0 tiles, so we're going to set it to 0. The first thing we want to do is to set this tile to the bottom left corner. The easiest way to do that is to use the go to, bottom, and left. So if we click, double click this, you'll see it jumps over here to the bottom left. Now the next thing we're going to do is set up a nested loop. And this is just a fancy way of saying a loop inside of a loop. So I'm going to set up two script variables, x and y. And then using two for loops, we're going to cycle through all the positions for tile on the XY plane. So we're going to do Y first and then X. We're also going to use the screen variables again. So we're going to go from screen bottom to screen top, then screen left to screen right. And to make sure we're jumping by the correct amount of distance, we're going to use the property of actor, and we're going to go height of self and width of self. We're going to use another go-to block, and we're going to set that to the positions that we just created. Now, if we run this program, tile moves really fast. And we can't even see that, and that's not what we want, because we want to fill the entire screen with tiles. Now to do that, we're going to use the clone block. And we're going to do that at every single point when we move across X and Y. So we create clone of self. And you know what? Let's go ahead and keep track of how many clones we are going to have in our tiles variable. We'll change tiles by 1. And at the end of all this, we'll turn the video back on. So if we run this now, we have an entire display of tiles, and we're ready to play the game. Now, what's the point of adding all these tiles if they're just going to sit there? We want to get rid of them. So what we're going to do is move on to this next thing that we like to call the game loop. So we're going to drag out a win key pressed. We're going to get all this started on the space button. And we're going to drag a forever loop. So now when the space button's pressed, we're going to start our game. set the effect of the clone. We're going to set this to opacity so that it starts to disappear as we wipe away. And we're going to set that to the motion on the clone itself. So now if we run this, go full screen, and click space, we should be able to start moving around, and the clones will start to disappear a little bit. But they don't stay gone if we stop moving. So to do this, we're going to do a simple conditional. So we're going to go if greater than or equal. We're actually going to look for this in the operators. We're going to copy this video motion on self. And about 40 is good. Now, if the motion is greater than 40, we're going to delete the clone. And then we're also going to keep track of how many clones we're deleting using the tile variable from earlier. So we're going to change tiles by... negative 1. So if we run this one more time in full screen, click space, and start wiping away. The tiles disappear, and they disappear forever. Now this is perfect. Now let's make this a real game. Last thing we need to add is a way to keep the score. So we're going to go in, add an actor, we're going to choose blank. Now we don't need this dot code, so we're going to get rid of it for now. Delete, delete. On start, we're going to give a little message for new players that's just going to say, click space to get started, just so they know how to play and it's easy. We're going to do this by using the label. There we go. Click play to start. We're going to move our actor up to the top corner. And we're going to set a high level so it doesn't get covered by the tiles. Now, when we click space, we're going to want to reset the timer. So we have a convenient reset timer block. Then we're going to open up with a repeat while. So we want this timer to keep going while we play the game. And we know how much time we have left in the game based off how many tiles have been cleared from the screen. So if we go to operators, greater than or equal again. We use tiles greater than or equal to 1. We want to set our label to show how many tiles we have left. So we can copy and paste this tile, and then we can add a new block using the plus and minus and hit left. Now if you include a little space before left, it'll make it easier to read while we're playing. Now when the game is over, I want to display the score to the user. So we're going to add the say block. I like the stylized one because we can make it all fancy and cool later. And we're going to do, you win, in space, add spot for tiles. So we're actually going to use the timer here. Convenient with the reset timer block. You win in blank, space, seconds. And I like to use the center message box. So now if we start this game over, click play, go to full screen, we get the click play to start in the corner. So as we click space to start, open it up, click space, it tells us how many tiles we have left. And as soon as we get going, we can start to clear them out. And you'll see the timer goes down as I'm playing. So we have 35 left. Oh, we're close. And I won in 14 seconds. There we go. It's a great score. I'm sure you guys might do better. Now, one last thing before we go. You may have noticed that in the demo, all the blocks got colorful before they disappeared. Now that's an easy fix. If we go back to tile, we can click on the set effect block and change this to color. So now when we run this project again, go full screen and click space, you'll notice that the blocks get all colorful before they disappear, which is awesome and much more colorful than the first time. So we're gonna stop this. We've also made this code easy enough so we can actually just change this costume to whatever we want, and you can even add Cody back. Instead of clearing tiles, you could be clearing Cody's off the screen. And that's the beauty of using Tynker. You can do whatever you want, and you can make this game yours. Let's say you wanted to add tiles that were harder to scrub away. You can change the value of this conditional, and it'll be good to go. I'm excited to see what you guys can make. Share it with your friends and share it on the community page. And I'll see you guys next time.